identified as part of the festival's first-time initiative called People of the River, and they'll be sharing their stories during the festival. So joining me in studio to share more is James Xia, one of the People of the River, and Edmund Wong, Assistant Manager for Marketing and Communications of Singapore River One, the organizer of this year's Singapore River Festival. Thank you very much, gentlemen, for coming in and speaking to me tonight. Edmund, why don't I start with you first? How is this year's Singapore River Festival different from previous years?
So in our previous years, we had international acts coming in from Spain and from France. So this year, we are focusing more on Singapore homegrown talent. So one of the things that we are highlighting this year and shining a light on literally is the Singapore night regatta. So we're calling it the Regatta Rumble for the first time ever. And other things such as we have our first LED kite show called Skylight Spectacular over at Clarke Quay Central. And we also have our first light projection rave over at Clarke Quay. So things, such programming is curated by for the first time by locals and is different from the foreign acts that we've had in the past years.
So it seems to be very bright with a lot of lights this
That's
year.
Right.
Yeah, it's also themed Turn on the River. So why this theme though?
Turn up the river.
Turn up the river.
Because this year it's all about amplifying whatever the Singapore River has to offer. Singapore River is a place where there's a lot of entertainment, great F&B, delicious things to eat. So we're shining a light and we are turning the volume up literally, and turning the lights up literally as well.
Okay. Well, James, I want to bring you into this conversation. You've been identified as one of the people of the river. You know, give us an idea of why the Singapore River is so significant for you.
The thing is, as a people of the river, I would be the second generation. So who are these people? These people, I would think, is like, you know, those from maybe China, from India, from Malaya, and the surrounding areas, you know, to come to Singapore together as migrants.
Right.
My father, when in the 1930s, from China, came to Singapore by boat and on the Singapore River.
Mm-hmm.
So I thought that this is for, you know, the younger generations to know how, you know, where they come from.
Right.
They are not natives of the Singapore Island.
Yeah.
But they came here together, and to me,
right,
it means to say how my father, you know, the first time took a little boat 1 week to reach Singapore.
Right. So you'll be sharing some of those stories as well
yes,
with us. You know, but very quickly, what are some of the changes that you see now, you know, at the Singapore River?
Oh yeah, the changes I see in plenty. Because basically, you know, as I'm now 69 years old, and when I was young, about 9 or 10, the first time my father brought me to see the Singapore River. I see the changes most is when in the 1960s, you know, along the Singapore River, there's a row of these food stalls. Yes. And at that time, the water was so dirty and there's a stench because the hawkers and the customers, after they take their food, they just throw it and dump into the Singapore River. So the water is so dirty that, you know, some tourists, you know, sarcastically say that actually the water in the Singapore River actually should water them as smelling salt.
Oh dear. These are some of the good changes that have happened. Thank you so much for coming in and sharing you know, with us your insights. And thank you, Edmund. I've been speaking there with Edmund Wong, the Assistant Manager for Marketing and Communications of Singapore River One, organizer of this year's Singapore River Festival, and James Xia is part of the People of the River initiative. And coming up after the break, an update on this mobile parking app and